I wish I went to see the Arctic Ocean. Icy expanses, like from another world. The travel probably costs too much for my tight budget. But the reason I cannot anymore is because the Arctic ice could disappear in 7 years from now. This is what a new study warns about in Nature. And this comes as a surprise. The latest IPCC report planned it to happen over a large spread of time. The previous IPCC report even predicted it to happen around 2080, the earliest. You might think Arctic ice disappearing is anecdotal, but actually, it might mean we are losing the battle to climate change. So, what is different in this study? What are the impacts of an ice-free Arctic? And what does it mean for the climate battle? 2030. This year could be the first one to see a full ice-free September in the Arctic. Why September? Because this is the end of the summer, the moment the hemisphere reaches its maximum heat accumulation, and the moment when the Arctic ice sheets are at their minimum. To be fair, the study I present you today gives a period rather than a date. In the best case scenario, this would happen around 2050, but in the worst, it could happen before 2030. It's no secret that the ice sheets already started melting since years. Scientists have been monitoring the ice caps and warning us about their melting since 1968. The problem is, they melt faster than all available simulations. So how is this study different, you might say? First, it calculates the real sea ice area using satellite images from 1979 to 2019. This drastically reduces the observed uncertainty the previous studies had. In the past, scientists also used satellite images, but they split them into a grid, using a threshold of 15% to define whether a grid cell contains ice or not. Second, this study simulates greenhouse gases' impact on sea ice for all months of the year. This accounts for the gradual melting, when majority of other studies focused on September alone. With these data, the scientists can now compare the projections with the SSP scenarios from the IPCC. And no matter how much we reduce our emissions, the summer ice sheets in the Arctic could disappear between 2030 and 2050. Now I know, some of you might just be wondering, why would ice caps melting be a bad news for the climate change? And who is this weird accent guy speaking? Well, both are fair and important questions. To answer both, we first need to understand another concept in climatology, the tipping points. Nature is composed of many balanced ecosystems. Some of these balances are global, and some others regional. All living organisms are part of these ecosystems, adapted to their surroundings. Any radical changes to these balances require adaptation, whether to survive temperatures increase, food supply change, or any other disruptions. Earth and life exist since billions of years. During all this time, these changes forced adaptation via DNA mutations, or in other words, natural evolution. A change in climate does not mean Earth will die. Ecosystems will find new balances, whether favorable for existing living creatures or not. If those changes are too harsh, too abrupt, massive extinctions will occur. Only the fittest survive. Of course, as humans, we are different than other living organisms. We are the only known species capable to willingly shape its environment. And the scale of our footprint is gigantic. Whether to serve beliefs or fulfill greed, satisfaction, and energy desires. But question is, will we be able to shape ecosystems with what is happening? In the 2021 report, IPCC defined the tipping point as a critical threshold beyond which a system reorganizes, often abruptly and/or irreversibly. But even if this term defines a change that can be sudden, It should not be seen as something happening overnight. It is more a profound change, taking years. And sometimes, these changes start happening in a sneaky way, long before we discover them or understand them. So far, the scientists identified multiple tipping elements. You probably heard about the dying low-latitude coral reefs and the mountain glaciers loss. Those are the regional ones. But there is another type of tipping elements, the core global ones, and their impact is on the entire planet. Antarctica and Greenland are covered with kilometers thick ice sheets. Scientists estimate their melting will happen around 1.5 degrees increase in Greenland and, depending on the regions, between 1.5 and 7.5 degrees for Antarctica. This melting will add millions of tons of fresh water in the oceans, rising its level by more than 60 meters in total, causing massive extinctions in marine life and, more importantly, causing a temperature runaway by disrupting plankton CO2 absorption. Ocean currents are other global core tipping elements. For example, in the Arctic meridional overturning circulation, or AMOC, convection between cold and warm waters warms up the American and European coasts while tempering low-latitude ones. Scientists estimate their tipping point at 4 degrees increase. The freshwater could slow or block these currents, as freshwater remains atop the salty one. And by the way, there are evidences now that the AMOC already started weakening. Equatorial rainforests, another tipping element, are one of the most important carbon sinks in the planet. It is expected to reach a point of no return around 3.5 degrees increase, if deforestation does not destroy it before, of course. And there is still one important global tipping element, which we will see later. Arctic summer sea ice itself is not a tipping element, but the winter one is. Its tipping point was estimated around 6.3 degrees. This study now says that even at 1.8 degrees, the scenario where we drastically reduce our emissions, the Arctic sea ice will start disappearing soon. It was also interesting to notice that the whole paper does not even mention the 1.5 degree scenario anymore. Without making any assumptions here, temperatures are already at 1.15 degrees. And multiple scientists already called the community to state in the obvious. In any case, if these tipping elements cross the point of no return, they can totally change the face of the Earth. So how will that impact us, humans? So far, only icebreakers were able to navigate the Arctic Ocean, only in certain areas, and only during certain months of the year. Obviously, strip the ice from it, the ocean will become navigable, even for less equipped commercial ships. On one hand, this could have a positive effect. Shipping routes will be shorter, reducing emissions by the same. But on the other hand, this is additional risks for the ecosystems there. Oil leaks, accidents, and adrift containers could increase in a place where cleaning and rescue will continue to be harsh. The other effect here will be the change in geopolitical balances, especially since the recent events we all know. From the perspective of climate, this could be very bad. In some areas, Arctic Ocean exceeds 5 kilometers in depth. Strip the ice from it, and it will have much lesser albedo. The more sunlight it will absorb, the warmer it will get. And this can start a domino effect on the surrounding areas. First, North America, Europe, and Asia will lose one of their main stabilizers, meaning more extreme weather events. Remember wildfires, summer heat domes, and winter cold snaps? Well, prepare to see more. And obviously, the second impact will be more ice melting. Although the speed will probably depend on our emissions, the ice melting will add more fresh water in the ocean. This alone could trigger the ocean current's tipping points and disrupt the plankton CO2 sink. Of course, not to mention sea level rise, to which Greenland alone would add an additional 7 meters. And even if the full melting could take centuries, we could start seeing the first impacts in the next few decades or so. But probably the biggest impact from Arctic Ocean warming could be linked to the tipping element I kept for the end. Around the Arctic Ocean, there is a frozen soil in Canada, Europe, and Russia, the permafrost. It already started melting, creating lakes, and collapsing on its own weight. Problem is, as it melts, it releases carbon trapped since millennia. Scientists estimate permafrost melting will release twice as much carbon to the atmosphere than it currently contains. And this is not only CO2, but also methane, which, as a reminder, has up to 30 times more greenhouse effect. If you want to know more about this phenomenon, watch this video next about permafrost having probably triggered the temperature runaway 56 million years ago. Time is running out, but there is still hope. So, to answer the remaining question, why the Arctic ice melting might mean we are losing the climate battle? Well, because the next step could be permafrost melting and a temperature runaway. Oh, by the way, my name is Khalid, and I talk about interesting science.